everyone, it's Nonna Grace. And for those of you that worried about me and my tooth, it's feeling much better. I'm back. I'm on the medicine. It's gonna take it another probably 6 days, I think I have to be on it, before the infection should be completely gone, because every now and then it still wants to twinge a little, but it's better. It's so much better. Okay, today I'm going to talk about a little bit of, I'm going to elaborate on Bob's video today on Mountain Crest Farms. That's Bob's channel. I will put that in the information below so that you can find him. But what he was talking about was what the farmers would, or now I say what the farmers would say, but he was saying what country sayings and country beliefs. Like he was talking about is basically things that the country people would say. He was wondering if it was a southern thing or a northern thing. And there's things that he was saying, which I will link that video so that you can find it, so you can hear what he was saying. And I'm going to tell you what things that people say in this area, which is probably more up north. Mm-hmm. I'm the up north kind of person, I guess.
More the north.
Even though I'm in the east.
But we're still northern United States.
Northern, yeah. We're the northerns. Okay. When it's going to get cold out, the things that we look for to find out how much snow are we going to have this year. And it's always a dread when we get the snow. Some of you that never see snow are so happy when you do get the little dusting, but your dustings are gone by noon. Ours stay maybe a week or two and more. And then when just about when it melts, they pour more on us. And so ours never really goes away. But what we look for is, like, where are the honeybees building their nests? If you happen to find a honeybee nest, you hope it's close to the ground. Because if it's close to the ground in the trees, that means there's not going to be very much snow, because the bees, they wouldn't build their nest so close to the ground if it was going to be a bad winter. They would be high up in the tree. So you're looking for the honeybees if you find a nest. You want it to be low. And then also, when we would go on the walk with the kids, depending on how many acorns we would walk across or the horse chestnuts, if there's a lot on the ground, you can bet it's going to be a bad winter, because the squirrels are gathering all those nuts and that, whatever animals eat those, the acorns and the horse chestnuts. If there's just a tiny bit on the ground, then you know we're going to have a good, easy winter. Pine cones are another thing we look for. We look to see whether there's pine cones are high in the tree or if there's a lot more down low. And if there's a lot or a little, because sometimes that determines whether it's going to be a tough winter or not. So I like the pine cones to be low and not too many. This way I'm hoping for a mild winter. Then I also look at the caterpillars. I have driven down the road, stopped the car, because you can see the caterpillars going across the country road, and you see a lot of them. So I would actually stop the car, get out of my car, and walk to different caterpillars just to check, because maybe this one has a lot of dark in the front and a little dark in the back and a lot in the brown in the middle. Maybe that one is the same, hopefully, or whatever you find, hopefully they all look the same. And that's how we decide whether we're gonna have a good beginning, bad beginning, how long in the middle should be nice, and what the end should be like. So it's the darker it is in the front, and the darker it is in the back, the stormier the weather. You want a lighter brown in the middle. And so,
well, a lighter brown on the head and tail too, or a light.
Well, yeah, you could have light, but most of the time they're dark. It's unfortunate, but you could have a caterpillar that was light, then dark, then light, then dark, then light again. That means you're gonna have an easy into the winter, and then a little bit of storm, and then nice weather, and then some more storm, and then uneasy out. And in the spring, when the weather starts to get to where it looks like it's going to be nice, you think, oh good, we've got good weather. Well, no, you hear the peepers. The peepers are making noise and you hear them, but they've got to be frozen 3 times before the spring actually gets here. And there was something I was thinking in the fall. Indian summer. That's what I was thinking of. We could have Indian summer. Like you could have a cold snap, and then all of a sudden you get this really nice warm weather. That's our Indian summer. And then when that's gone, you can bet you're going to have cold weather because there's nothing else coming but cold weather. Now, when I was younger, my mother had said that there was one of her aunts or great aunts used to tell her that if you want to predict the weather. Now, I should have been a meteorologist because I was always interested in the weather. As a very young person, I would write down the weather. But she said, if you want to predict the weather, now this only works for your area, so you can't travel a couple states over and write down the weather and think that's what's going to be happening at home, because it doesn't happen. You got to be in your own area. And what you do is the day after St. Lucie's Day, which is the 14th of December, that is the first day that you write down the weather. St. Lucie's Day is the 13th of December. So the day after. So what you do is you write down as early in the morning as possible, close to midnight, what it's doing outside. You write down if it's snowing, if it's windy, if it's not snowing, what the barometer is. I always wrote down the barometer. I write down the how hard the wind is, what direction the wind is. And you do this if you want to be real accurate, you do it every 15 minutes. If you want to be a little less accurate, you do it every half hour. If you really don't care, you just do a general thing all day, which sometimes that's what I've been doing lately because I've gotten lazy. But I used to write it down at least every half hour, and I could tell you what day was going to be a good day, what day was going to be a bad day in that month. And you do this all the way up until Christmas Day. Christmas Day, you don't know what it's going to be. That would be December. But you don't know, because Christmas Day is when, December is when you start the cycle over again. So December is always a mystery, always. So you can do every month of the year. So the 14th would be January, the 15th would be February, and so on and so forth, all the way up to the 25th. What I worked with, this was funny. It was funny, but it wasn't funny. When I was working, I would write down the weather, and I had a calendar there. And we had beautiful weather. It was like 70 degree temperatures. Beautiful, beautiful weather. And this was like Monday, Tuesday was beautiful weather. And I had written on there for like Wednesday or Thursday was going to be a blizzard. And they all kind of just, they were laughing at me. They thought I was just ridiculous. Well, we had the blizzard. I think it was the blizzard of 77, if you recall. They talked about that a lot. That was so bad that those of us that were at work couldn't go home, and those that were at home couldn't get to work. It was terrible. And after that, nobody laughed about my calendar, but when they were laughing at my calendar, I told them I would take it down and I would never bring them another one. So then they would want to know what the weather's going to be, and I go, I don't really have to listen to the weatherman, because he knows what the weather's going to be. You thought I didn't know, and so I'm just going to not tell you. But I did share it with the people that were my friends, and a couple of girls planned their weddings on, according to my calendar. And my brother used to plan his, when he was going to cut his hay. A lot of times he could only get two hay seasons in, and if he listened to me, then he would get three in. And when they did some building of my barn, the big, big barn, I told him I wanted him to build it in August of that year, and he wanted to know why I wanted August. And I says, because we're not going to get much rain, we're going to be pretty darn dry, and I want it built in August. So they built it in August, and sure enough, we had beautiful weather. I used to plan things like that. And also my husband, when he was working in the vineyards, they would ask, what's the weather going to be, because they would try to get their grapes scheduled when I said it was going to be higher temperatures, because if the higher temperature, the higher the sugar content, the more money the farmer could make on his grapes. So that was what the weather did. I was a weather predictor and I enjoyed it. Well, I want to tell you too, I was going to do this at the beginning, I forgot, but I got a package in the mail today from the smartest dog in the West, Fox. He's the smartest dog. It says, Fox, the smartest dog in the West. I will put his link down too. We're going to open this up and see what's in there. I do know what's coming to me because I had won it, but I have to show you. Oh my goodness. I got a hand-painted lizard. Look at this. Isn't that beautiful?
Cute.
It's cute. I'm going to do a magic trick, so you watch. Here it goes. Woohoo! Look at that. I would model this. It fits me nicely. Look at this, my shoulders. It's a nice t-shirt. Look at that. Oh, I'm going to come closer, but I can't because I can't see it. I'd have to stand on something. I'm pretty short. I'll stand up here, maybe. There. No, it's good. It's in there. I see it. Ta-da! Here it comes. I'm going to loosen it a lot so it doesn't squeak. There we go. Look at that. Ooh, la la. Isn't that a pretty lizard? That's beautiful. Look at that. Whoa. Pretty nifty. Okay, that's that. Thank you so much. And no, I am not a t-shirt person, but I plan to wear this one. It looks like I'm wearing a white shirt when I get up close, though, because the picture is way down there. I'll pull it up so you can see it there. Look at that. It's so beautiful. Look at that. I love it. Oh, my goodness. I love it. Look at the paint. Look at the colors. It's gorgeous.
Bright and vibrant.
Bright and vibrant. That's the way I like it. Oh, look, look, look. It's got a sign down the bottom. Oh, my goodness. Thank you. Thank you so much. I really, really like it. Thank you. And on that note, I shall see you all tomorrow. Bye.